for blocks. We did this because of that. We did that because of that, et cetera, et cetera. Just to get people started. Because, you know, the one thing about Wargamers was, and this shocked me. Well, it didn't really shock me, but, you know, it was a pleasant surprise. I was always a bright kid, you know, and I was often the smartest one in the room. But it's like a kid like me going to an Ivy League school, which I also did, but I did after being in the Army for 3 years, which gave me another edge. Sure. I found out when I met Wargamers was I was not the smartest guy in the world. They were often weird. You know, we had a lot of characters. We still have. Anybody, no matter who they get into a room full of Wargamers, you can't assume you're the smartest guy in the world, no matter how smart you actually are. Because it basically requires a certain set of mental tools, which unfortunately is rare. That's why the market was never that huge. And that's why, you know, the war games hobby really has not grown much, even with the computers. Because the strategic games, as they call them, or what we would call war games, which don't really have a discrete category in computer, what they call computer war games, you know, it's still a niche.
Oh, totally. Yeah.
Yeah.
What has expanded? I mean, I pointed out this before, and maybe it existed. We just didn't know it was. If you go on BGG, Board Game Geek, or Console World, generally speaking, about 50%, maybe 40% of all the gamers, war gamers, what we consider war gamers, are outside the North America.
Oh, yes.
It's really big. It really is.
Yeah, well, that's something else. Trends. I'm big on trends. What happened in the 60s and the 70s was you had the new generation of geeks. People, again, these are things most people aren't aware of, but me being a history nut, I became aware. High school only became commonplace in the United States, for the majority of the population in the 1920s and 30s. Before that, eighth grade was perfectly acceptable for most jobs. And college, for everyone, didn't become de rigueur until, you know, the 70s and 80s.
Right.
So in the 70s, 60s and 70s, you had your first generation of universal high school graduation, and a lot more kids headed for college. So you had these educated, I mean, the geeks were always there, even when they were illiterate. But now you have this huge, and this was the baby boom generation. So you had this huge flood of people, young people coming up, and a lot of them were educated, and there were no computers for them to play with.
Right.
So what else was out there? There were war games.